Hey guys, thanks for tuning in. I just wanted to make a quick video for you going over exactly what we're doing here as far as pre-recording the service goes. So at my church currently, we're pre-recording our worship service and then we're editing that into one cohesive video and then we're live streaming the pre-recorded worship and then we're going live to our pastor or another speaker. So it's kind of half and half, half live stream, half pre-recorded. So I want to walk you through what it looked like Thursday night for our practice and when we recorded the worship. And then I also want to go through exactly what's going on behind the scenes on my computer as far as the post-production goes. So I hope that this gives you some ideas as you listen in, even if you don't pre-record the service or if you're looking to pre-record worship or the whole service or anything like that. Hope this kind of sparks some ideas or at least gives you an idea of what other churches are doing. Because I think that's honestly, for me, that's one of the most interesting things or the biggest help that I see when I watch, you know, videos on YouTube of other churches. Not necessarily looking for exactly step-by-step how to do it, but just ideas. Sometimes from seeing other churches and how they operate, how they do these things, you can kind of get insights and ideas just how to implement certain things into your own church or your own situation. So I hope that that makes sense and I hope that this helps you do just that.
All right, so the band's practicing right now. It's Thursday night. We're pre-recording the service and I just want to show you a little bit about what we're running. All right, so back here at the soundboard, I actually have my MacBook Pro here. And we're plugging that in into the Behringer X32, our soundboard, and that's actually coming out of the card out on the Behringer X32 into my MacBook Pro, into Logic Pro, and that's what I'm using to record all of this. I am recording all the channels individually. Later, I can go back in and I can mix that how I want for the recording. We're recording the audio completely separate from the video. We just have a couple cameras set up. We have the Blackmagic Pocket Cinema camera, 4K, and then of course, the Sony A6300, which is this camera right here. We have those two up on just tripods. We're keeping it simple. I'm just then taking that back into my computer and I'm editing all that up together in Premiere Pro.
All right, so now we're done filming. I'm back at my desk. Let's hop onto the computer and let me show you exactly what I do as far as post-production goes for pre-recording the service. So I hop back into Logic and here are all the tracks that I've already mixed. I've already done everything here, but I just kind of want to walk you through what I did. So I took all the stems that we recorded from the Behringer X32 here and I mixed those properly for each of the songs. We did two songs, so I mixed those. I also added the multi-tracks into Logic as well and sync those up with the songs. The band played with the click, so I was able to just drop the multi-tracks right in. And I didn't use much, and everything that I did use was mixed pretty low, but I had it in there anyway, just for some extra keys or pads, so it's there if I need it. So once that was mixed, I went ahead and bounced that out, and then imported that audio file into Premiere Pro, and that's where we'll go next. All right, so now we're in Premiere Pro, and here's my full finished timeline here. I imported the track from Logic. Here it is. And of course, I laid down the video footage of our two cameras, the Blackmagic Pocket Cinema camera and the Sony A6300. Also, of course, added lyrics in here. Just went ahead and did that in here just so that it was done. Didn't have to do it live or anything like that later. And so the simplest way to do it is just to come over here to the type tool in Premiere and then you click on the screen and you can, you know, drop in whatever text you want. I found a font and size that looked good on the screen and I went ahead and copied that and just changed the text as I went along for each of the lyrics. So pretty simple. So if you want to copy what I'm using for lyrics on here, there it is, Montserrat Medium at 75 point font. So here's another little pro tip. Instead of copying and Command C, Command V, copy and pasting all of these little lyrics boxes here, click on the one you want to copy and then hold down the Option key on your keyboard and then just click and drag away. And doing that just makes a new copy that you can move and do whatever you want with. So it's a lot quicker than doing Command C, Command V when copying these. So there's a little tip for you if you didn't know that already. All right, so that's pretty much what these two songs look like here in the worship set looks like, the two songs with the text overlaid over top of them. Let's go back here and look at the beginning because there's a lot of stuff here at the beginning. I actually went ahead and made a countdown specifically for the live stream. A lot of layers here, a lot of stuff going on. I actually did a lot of this in Adobe After Effects last week, but this week I went ahead and moved a lot of it over here just for simplicity's sake. This is the old After Effects file that I linked over there, so that's not really being used right now, but it's still there. So this layer here is all backgrounds, and I actually got all these backgrounds from Visual Media Church for free, so that's great. I'll go ahead and link them down below if you want to check out their backgrounds and stuff like that, but they have some really nice looking backgrounds, and some of them are for free, so that's nice as well. And then this layer right here is just the numbers countdown, so this layer is just the clock ticking, which I made in After Effects and then exported as a video layer. That I could overlay on top of stuff here. And then I also added some text over here. Some of this text is actually, honestly, from a Peter McKinnon motion graphics pack, just because it's easy, it's quick, and you don't have to keyframe anything yourself. So if you're interested in that as well, I'll link that down below too. Once the countdown reaches zero, it fades to black, and so that's how it transitions into the worship set. As the weeks go on and on, I may go back and tweak this countdown a little bit. If I come up with something I really, really like, then maybe I'll share the full thing with you guys. So now if I come back over here to the very end of the video, the pastor comes back up and has a ending exhortation, prayer, that type of thing. And then from there, after the end of that, I just fade into a little graphic just encouraging people in the comments to engage with each other, to say hey, to reach out to each other. So that goes on for about 60 seconds, and then it transitions into the bumper video. So I just went ahead and put the bumper video straight into this video, just so that it's all one cohesive piece. And then once I hit play on this one video, I don't have to play anything else all the way up until the pastor or whoever's speaking goes live. And so this whole video is everything from the 15-minute countdown all the way to the very end after the worship through to the message. Anyway, that's just a look at what we're doing here. I hope this helps you. If there's any way that I could go into more depth into any of these situations, how we're live streaming, what software, what gear we're using, feel free to let me know. I'm planning on making more tutorials around this subject as we're in this time where we don't know how long we'll be sitting here alone in our churches, making content, making videos, live streaming, that type of thing to everyone at home as everyone's social distancing. So let me know what you thought. I hope that this helped break this down for you, kind of spark some interest and some ideas for you. And as always, again, thanks for watching. Thanks for taking the time out of your day to watch this video. If you liked it or if this brought you any value at all, I'd love it if you drop a like and a comment. Tell me what you liked, what you thought. That's it for me today. Hope you guys have a great week. I'll see you guys in the next video.